Joining us is San Francisco Supervisor Rafael Mandelman, who is at the forefront of one of the biggest issues in the Bay Area and in the state, as a matter of fact. We're talking about the people on the street, the people who sort of waft between jail and hospitals, but also come in contact with the rest of us. Mm-hmm. And recently we had a homeless person in San Francisco who may or may not have been in the right mental mind, might have been on meth, who grabbed a woman outside of her Embarcadero condominium complex and threw her to the ground, saying, "I need to save you from the robots taking over the world."
Yep.
Now, the question is, he was released shortly thereafter on his own recognizance. Why don't we have a place for somebody like that to stay? I mean, they're clearly a problem to themselves. They could get in more trouble, and they're a problem to us because they could hurt somebody.
Yeah. Well, it was a mistake to let that guy out. And we do have places for people. But it sort of brings up all the worst fears everyone has about the folks who we pass. Most folks are not dangerous, you know, and most folks are mainly a danger to themselves and need help. But that guy clearly should not have been out on the streets.
But it's difficult because you and I have both taken a look at this issue, and I want to compliment you for your work on this. You know, we had a budget analyst report that said, you know, San Francisco has been systematically reducing the number of mental health beds it has in its system and not requiring other hospitals to put them in.
Yeah.
So for the past 10 or 15 years, while we're talking about the problem of mental health on the streets, we haven't done anything. We've gone the other direction.
Well, we've tried to, you know, in the last budget, for example, we expanded out some mental health beds, but it hasn't kept up with what we've lost over the last decades. And, you know, even in the private market, these residents...
Wait. Yeah. Well, I'm going to call you on that, because while we expand the number of beds, it turns around that we don't have the staff to take care of the people in those beds, so they stay empty.
Yeah.
So, again, you sit there and go... How does that work?
Yeah, well, that was a unique situation at San Francisco General in a particular facility, which has gotten some attention this week. It's about 41 beds, and yes, they haven't had the staff there, and there's a ton of questions that raises for me about quality of patient care and patient safety. But, you know, those 27 beds are part of a 2,000-bed portfolio the city has. We are having hiring problems, but, you know, that's not the full...
This is a difficult population to work with.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's getting, in all aspects of life, it's getting harder to hire in San Francisco.
It's also a criminal justice issue because people say, well, they should be in jail getting help. But the jail is having a hard time staffing psychiatric workers because they don't think the jail is the right environment for it.
Well, and San Franciscans are very conflicted about the jail. You know, a few years ago, there was a proposal to build a new jail, and we didn't do it. So we now have several hundred prisoners in a terrible facility at 850 Bryant, which we're going to have to resolve as well.
There has been some talk about maybe taking the county jails or other unused federal or state facilities that may not even be in cities and using them as a sort of treatment centers. What do you think?
I think we are desperate for every space that we can find to put people, which is why that situation in general is troubling, that we did have these 45, 50 beds that could have been used and were not.
But do you think that the sort of philosophical questions will ever be resolved in a way that we can actually get a handle on this, or are we always going to be in this sort of catch-22 bind?
I think San Franciscans are going to continue to fight each other over this issue going forward, but I believe there is a clear majority that wants people to get care, that is willing to tolerate a little coercion to get people into placements. But there's definitely divided opinion.
There is, and we see that reflected every day on the streets of San Francisco, and not just San Francisco. I think you can see it in Alameda County as well. That's the state of where we are the most. We're the richest state in the union, and the highest, one of the highest poverty rates, right?
Yep.
You know, it's long been said that San Francisco was put on the map to give the rest of the country something to talk about.
Yeah.
Well, joining us is San Francisco Supervisor Rafael Mandelbaum, who actually did it again. Well, this time you have passed a resolution calling the National Rifle Association a terrorist organization, a domestic terrorist. Really?
Yeah. Yeah, well, I want to give credit where credit is due here. This is Supervisor Catherine Stephanie's legislation. I voted for it, but she is a long-time gun control activist. She was local director of Moms Demand Action for Gun Safety, and Supervisor Stephanie is tired. Every single meeting during roll call for introductions, she tells the story of the gun deaths that have happened that week. And she wanted to send a message, and clearly she did. We did. I think You know, there's been some skepticism expressed from some folks. I'm sort of sensing it from you a little bit. I've certainly gotten some emails from some of my constituents. But I will say,
let me ask you something about that. Are the emails from the constituents, what are you doing? Or are the emails saying, what are you doing when there's so many other things that need to be done?
It's a little, you know, some folks are saying both of those, that, you know, what is this? We have homelessness, we have a housing crisis, why are you spending your time on this? But I would say those folks are outnumbered by the people who are writing in and who are actually happy that she did this and we did this.
What is the goal? What is it? The goal, obviously, is to make news, right? To make a statement.
Maybe. I mean, I think one of the fears that people that I have is that we become inured to this. We see these killings in churches and schools and festivals, you know, and they come so regularly that we just accept that this is part of life. And I think that a resolution like this is to raise the profile, remind everyone this is unacceptable. This has to stop, and stopping it has to be a priority for our politics.
Okay, so speaking of our politics, it appears to be signaling from D.C. once again that an assault weapons ban is not in the works. And that signal is not just coming from the Republicans, it's coming from the Democrats as well. And here in heavily blue San Francisco are a number of Democrats, including House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. Why don't we call them out?
Well, I think Nancy Pelosi is doing everything she can to get as much gun safety legislation as she can. The reality is the Republicans control the Senate. There's a Republican president who seems what he believes.
Well, wait. Let's be honest about that. Yeah. There are Democrats that don't want to have to vote on this. They just wanted to fob it off on the reaps and say, we're not getting to it. But there are Democrats in parts of this country that do not want to vote on this.
And to that, you know, and if that's the case, then all the more reason for a deep blue city like San Francisco to be standing up and saying, hey, wait a minute, everybody. This really is an issue. We got to move on.
So the NRA has turned around and sued you. American tradition as well.
We hurt their feelings and they're upset. Yes.
And so now we're going to be spending money defending that.
Yeah. I mean, San Francisco, you know, has a proud tradition of taking a stand and sometimes, having to defend its position in courts. And in the end, if this moves the gun control conversation and moves us closer to background checks or assault weapons ban or anything at some point, it'll be worth that cost.
Yeah. And I guess if we put it up against banning plastic straws or fur or a few other things, it might actually have a little more seriousness to it?
Well, I think banning plastic straws is serious. I think there's a giant plastic ball in the middle of the ocean that we want to stop adding to, and so that's a reasonable thing. But, you know, I spend most of my time, as you know, working on substance use, mental health, homelessness. But I do think there's a space for San Franciscans to express our values and try to push the envelope.
And that space is the San Francisco Board of Supervisors. It has been for a long time. And under this directorship, it will continue to be not just the voice of the people, but the voice of the nation and the voice of the world.
Oh, my. Thank you, Phil.
Thank you for joining us. Rafael Maldeman.